the museum assistant here at the Sutliff Museum, and welcome back to our digital Victorian medicine series. So we're continuing our focus on the unexpected deadly things in the Victorian era, and today I want to talk about how the beautiful and iconic dresses of the Victorian era could potentially be deadly. Fashions changed drastically in the 63 and a half-ish years the Victoria reigned, but the styles often had common enough elements that the problems with them carried throughout the changing trends in ladies' wear. So to start, I want to talk about everyone's favorite Victorian fashion talking point, corsets. We're all used to seeing period films showing women getting so tightly laced in corsets they could barely breathe, and corsets really could do serious damage if they were laced improperly or too tightly, causing organ damage or even dislocating or breaking bones. These sorts of occurrences have been rather exaggerated by our modern tellings of history. Women were rarely laced up that tightly, usually only for very specific and special occasions, and women of all classes actually wore some kind of corset every day, and they generally provided some pretty good support, whether you were sitting at home or working in a factory or even working out in the field. The risks of the damage from improperly laced corsets did, however, lead to the creation of what was known as a health corset, which were tended to be made of elastic fabric and put significantly less pressure on the ribs than boned corsets. Now, another danger it could be posed was from the dyes that gave garments their brilliant colors. One notable example from that period that was everywhere, not just in dresses, was the color green, like on this dress here. Green pigments often use arsenic to create the deep and rich colors in them. For more on the specific dangers of the color green in the Victorian era, check out our video on the museum's wallpaper where I go into a lot more detail on it. Often, dresses were also made of many layers to accentuate the smallness of the waist, and those layers often dragged through the rather dirty city streets, picking up all kinds of disease-causing agents. One problem with these sorts of skirts is that they could not only infect the person wearing the dress, making them sick, they could also infect anyone coming in contact with or handling the dress, especially people who were tasked with cleaning the dresses. Even looking at later dresses with fewer layers, such as these later period dresses, you can see just how easy it was for clothes to come in contact with all kinds of disease, and they could easily perpetuate the spread if they weren't properly cleaned, which was often the case. These multiple layers could also cause problems depending on what they were made of. So lighter dresses often use light fabrics like tulle and the crinolines used to create the wide hoop skirts popular in the 1850s and 1860s, more Scarlett O'Hara than these two here. Those materials were often very flammable and they could catch fire quite easily. And the size of the skirts meant that women ran the risk of standing just a little too close to an open fire. These layers could also cause problems for women in the working class. The big skirts and many layers could get caught in machinery and factory, leading women to be injured or killed. Thanks for watching. Please call or email us if you have any questions, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on social media at the Sutliff Museum for more information about the abolitionist movement, the Victorian era, and of course, the Sutliff family. Thanks for watching.